दिस इज एनालॉग एंड डिजिटल कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम्स, द पेपर कोड इज EC501, टोटल नंबर ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट अवार्ड इज 36, द कॉन्टैक्ट पर वीक इज 3 लेक्चर्स एंड द क्रेडिट इज ऑल्सो 3. Myself, Dr. Indranath Sarkar, Associate Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering at JS College of Engineering. Welcome to Analog and Digital Communication. This is Module 5, Digital Modulation Techniques. There are 5 course outcome of this subject. The first one deals with, it explains the importance of analog and digital communication. That is the modulation and demodulation schemes. In this case, we are very much interested to grow the knowledge of the student towards the basic definitions of the modulation and demodulation part. The second course outcome deals with the analyze analog communication system for their signal to noise ratio, efficiency and bandwidth, because whenever students are dealing with the signals, they are very much interested to know about its power that can dominate the noise over the channel. So that is why signal to noise ratio plays important role for analog and digital communication, as well as its efficiency and bandwidth. When the signal is received by the receiver, the accuracy should be as high as possible. The third course outcome statements is to compare the advantage of various pulse modulation technique and analyze their system performances. And the fourth one deals with the demonstrating signal representation. So this is one of the most important part of the course, that is how to represent the signal or signal constellation, because once the signal position is known, therefore we can describe the noise margin or noise cloud around the signal vector tip, so that the amount of noise that can contaminate the signal will have a prediction. So that is one way to check the communication system suitable for a certain area. Analyze various digital communication techniques can compute the bit error performance and compare their advantages and limitations. So this is the last outcome, which is dealing with the efficiency of the digital communication system, in which the bit error rate as well as several types of error cases, that is type 1, type 2 errors, will be discussed here, so that students will be able to demonstrate such factors. There are 5 modules in this subject. The module 1 deals with the introduction, where the introductory concept of the communication system will be discussed, and thereafter the basic knowledge of the analog communication and digital communication and their correlation, that is interdependency of those two communication system over the timeline. And the second module deals with the random processes. The random process it deals with certain mathematical examples as well as principles, in which the statistical characterization of the signal will be analyzed. And the module 3 deals with the pulse modulation. The pulse modulation basically analog communication technique, and it is also the bridge between the analog and digital communication technique, because the pulse modulation produces pulses corresponding to instantaneous magnitude of the analog signal. Several categories of pulse modulation are also to be discussed in this module. And thereafter, the module 4, which is signal vector representation. So if signal vector is properly represented, then we can predict the amount of noise that can contaminate a particular signal, whether the signal will withstand with respect to that noise or not. So all these things could be predicted. Digital modulation techniques will be discussed here, and differential pulse code modulation to shift keying techniques, all these things will be discussed in the last module. The prerequisites of this analog and digital communication is the knowledge of signal vector representation, characteristics and of additive white Gaussian noise, geometric representation of signals, synthesizer and analyzer, signal vector, signal space, Euclidean space, etc. And this is the corresponding COPO mapping for the analog and digital communication. There are five course outcome statements which are related to the program outcome vertical with three different weightages. The first one is the highest weightage, numerically 3, medium weightage is 2, and the lowest weightage is 1. So why it is 3 given? Because program outcome 1, 2, 3 are the corresponding knowledges of engineering, as well as program outcome 10 and 11 deals with the communication and project management and finance. So in this case, we are giving higher weightage to each of these course outcome mostly, and there is a low weightage are getting program outcome 5 and 6 because it is the theoretical subject in which the modern tool uses and engineer and society impact are less, and almost environment and sustainability ethics, these are coming less to this subject. So depending on that, this COPO mapping has been introduced. The course objective of this analog and digital communication is to familiarize students with the fundamental of analog and digital communication systems, to provide students with tools for communication signal analysis, to familiarize students with various techniques for amplitude modulation and demodulation of analog signals, to develop the student's ability to determine the effects of receiver frequency and phase errors in synchronous modulation scheme systems, to familiarize students with techniques for generating and demodulating narrow band and wide band frequency and phase modulated signals, to familiarize students with basic techniques for generating and demodulating pulse code modulated signals, to familiarize. Now here some problems will be solved. Now this is the first question. The Cauchy random variable has the following probability density function, that is probability density function fx of x, where x is the random variable, is given by small b by pi divided by b square plus x minus a whole square. The real number 0 is less than b, and a is having the range minus infinity plus infinity. Now the distribution function of the random variable x will be which one out of these four possibilities? Now for this type of problem, we need to calculate the cumulative distribution function. Now cumulative distribution function can be calculated by integrating the probability density function. So it is very straightforward, because the probability density function is given, and if we directly integrate that function over the required range, so then we can get it is minus infinity to x fx of u du. So in this way, if we integrate, we have to just replace the probability density function, and thereafter we can replace v equal to u minus a, where dv equal to du, because a is constant. So dv equal to du, so this gives you fx of x is equal to b by pi minus infinity to x minus a dv divided by b square plus v square. So this is equal to b by pi 1 by b tan inverse V by V with the limit, lower limit and upper limit. So in this way, if we if we calculate, so it is not a difficult problem. It's quite straightforward, because the probability density function is given and we have to integrate over the range so that we can find out the equivalent equation. So we got the cumulative distribution function equation, and therefore it is matching with which option? It is matching with option number C, that is half plus 1 by pi tan inverse x minus a divided by b. Now this is the second problem. It tells the number of cars arriving at ICICI Bank drive-in window during 10 minute period is Poisson random variable capital X with small b equal to 2. So the probability that more than 3 cars will arrive during any 10 minute period, you have to find out, that is which of these 4 options will be correct. And also there is another question associated to the same text. The probability that no car will arrive is which fraction? Okay, no car. So probability of more than 3 car and probability of no car. In the first case, the time limit is 10 minute period. So therefore here probability density function equation you have to give. This is e to the power minus 2 summation 3 to the power k divided by factorial k delta of x minus k. So this probability density function helps us to find out the three cars, the probability that more than 3 cars arrive during last 10 minutes. So probability x greater than 0 is equal to 1 minus p of x less or equal to 3, and this gives us 1 minus p x of 0 minus p of x equal to 1 minus p of x equal to 2 minus p of x equal to 3. So probability of all the possible number of cars x equal to 0, there is no car, 1 car, 2 car or 3 car. So in this way we are getting 0.1429. So that means the option number B is the correct answer. Now the probability that no car will arrive is probability of x equal to 0 is e to the power minus 2 multiplied by 2 to the power 0 by factorial 0. So this is 0.135, therefore option number D is the correct answer. Now this is the third question. The third question states that the power reflected from an aircraft of complicated shape that is received by a radar can be described by an exponential random variable W. The density of W is, that is FW of W is equal to 1 by W0 e to the power minus W by W0 for W greater than 0 and equal to 0 otherwise. But W0 is the average amount of received power. The probability that the received power is larger than the power received on the average is which one? So here, as the probability density function is given, therefore it is easy to write that probability of W greater than W0 is equal to 1 minus P of W lesser equal to W0 is equal to 1 minus the cumulative distribution function. So one thing is very much clear, that once you are writing it is cumulative distribution function, that means the probability has been replaced by the cumulative distribution function, then you can replace the function with the help of probability density function, because the probability density function has the random variable small w. So if we find out if w of w0, that means the cumulative distribution function, then in place of small w we can put it is w0, so therefore it is 1 minus 1 minus 1 minus within bracket 1 minus e to the power minus e to the power w by w0 w0 by w0, so that gives you it is e to the power minus 1. Now this is the fourth question. Assume that the time of arrival of bird at Bhartpur sanctuary on a migratory route as measured in days from the first year January 1 is the first day as approximated as a Gaussian random variable capital X with AX equal to 200 and sigma X equal to 20 days. Given that if of 0.5 is equal to 0.6915, some numerical values are given for the cumulative distribution function. So this is a statement for which there are two problems. One problem is telling that what is the probability that birds arrive after 160 days but on or before 210th day. So you have to calculate this one. And the second problem is what is the probability of bird will arrive after 231st day. Now for the first question, we can write it is the probability of 160 less or equal to random variable less or equal to 120 is nothing but it is the probability density function 210 minus probability density function 160. So it is not 120, it is 210. So let's say it is the difference between the cumulative distribution functions is the range of probability. So this is equal to f of 210 minus 200 by 20 minus f of 160 minus 200 by 20. So that gives us f of 0.5 minus f of minus 2. And if we collect the values, it is 0.6915 plus 0.9773 minus 1. So that gives you 0.6687. So therefore, it is the option A. And the next, for the second question, it is probability of X greater than 231. That means 1 minus probability X of less or equal to 231. So this is 1 minus Fx, 231. So therefore, it could be written as 1 minus F of 231 minus 200 divided by 20. Because 200 is the mean and 20 is the standard deviation. So that is why we can easily write this one, and we can easily find out 1 minus f of 1.55 equal to 1 minus 0.9394, that is equal to 0.06606. So therefore, a C option. And for the previous question, the option is A. So this question has a longer statement, but the solution is not much longer, because once we have the idea of calculating probability in terms of the cumulative distribution function, then all the hurdles becomes easy. And this one is the fifth question. It tells the life of a system expressed in weeks is a Rayleigh random variable X for which probability density function is given X by 2000 into e to the power minus X square by 400 for 0 less or equal to X, otherwise it is 0. So you have to calculate the probability that the system will not last a full week. That means you have to calculate the probability, as well as another probability you have to calculate that the system lifetime will exceed in a year. So for the first one, we use the Rayleigh distribution function with a equal to 0 and b equal to 400. So for probability x less or equal to 1, it is the cumulative distribution function of random variable 1. So there is nothing but 1 minus e to the power 1 by 400, because the probability density function is given. So from that we can easily calculate this probability. So this is equal to 0.0025 or 0.25%. For the next option, it is probability of X greater than or equal to 52, and that is equal to 1 minus Fx of 52. So therefore, this is equal to 1 minus because the probability density function is given, only have to put the value and we can easily find out the answer is 0.0016 or 0.1%. So therefore, these are the 5 questions we have solved. So if we go through the 5 questions, so this was the first question where we have gone through the Cauchy's random variable and we have found that cumulative distribution function is sufficient to find out the corresponding probability, because here the distribution function of x is required. So directly distribution function helps us to find out the answer. For the second one, we needed the probability density function we have derived and written, and thereafter we got gone through the calculation of probability. So here cumulative distribution function is not required, you can directly write the probability. For the third question, we have gone through the probability density function and it has helped us to find out the probability for w greater than w0. And thereafter, the fourth question is also cumulative distribution function oriented. There are several values of cumulative distribution function given and we have calculated the corresponding probabilities. So therefore, the probability and cumulative distribution function are interrelated, and therefore we can take the benefit of either of these two. And this one is also probability density function given, and we have calculated the probability for the random variable and we have written this one. So this is all about the 5 questions. We hope the discussion is sufficient to make you efficient for solving such probabilistic equation. Thank you.